In the following part, the approach of the vehicle model is introduced. The parameterization of the vehicle model will be explained by making use of the relating GUI of the vehicle dataset. Additionally, the different coordinate systems available in CarMaker are going to be elaborated. Finally, we are going to have a look at the common parameterization techniques for vehicle models in CarMaker. The vehicle editor can be described as a starting basis to the user for parameterizing the vehicle model to its needs. Instead of using the term vehicle model, CarMaker tends to refer to datasets. It is based on the fact that technically CarMaker possesses only one vehicle model. The vehicle model, so-called vehicle dataset, provides only parameters which can be adjusted by the user. What happens in CarMaker is that the model is parameterized with various datasets to model different types of vehicles. The accessible parameters can be found in CarMaker. Graphical user interface, one has to choose the parameters tab in the upper menu string. Clicking on car opens the vehicle dataset. The provided data refer to the exemplary company car of IPG. In the GUI of the vehicle dataset, the individual parts of the vehicle can be subdivided as shown in the upper tabs. For example, all elements being relevant for the powertrain are accessible in the corresponding section. The side tab drive source includes all parameters related to the powering elements, as the engine or gearbox. The user can easily change the engine performance by adjusting the torque as well as the rotational speed. Taking the driveline section into account, the architecture of the driven axis can be changed, like from rear to front driven. To get a particular impression of the usage of, for example, let's change the mass of the vehicle body. The section body includes all parameters, e.g. mass for the vehicle, which is representing the vehicle's overall weight. In this case, we are going to increase the body mass about 100 kg. To save the changes, one has to save the new data while clicking in the upper right area file and save. In parallel, the file options offer some more options to manage datasets. New creates a new dataset with default settings. All parameters get filled automatically. As mentioned before, open is a possibility to load a new vehicle dataset or to save a vehicle dataset as seen under the save options. The import functions allows the user to replace a current vehicle component with the data of another vehicle dataset. You can see in this menu the different sub-elements to specify all domains of the vehicle to import in the appearing window. Let's change the data of the gearbox in the middle top, as well as the data for the tires on the bottom left. Hitting the import button, the user got the possibility to choose an available dataset of another parameterized vehicle in the project or the installation directory of CarMaker. Here you can see different vehicle datasets, which are provided by CarMaker that can be used by the customer. Let's take the data of the demo Audi R8. Assuming the same powertrain architecture here, the import process has replaced the transmission as well as the tire dataset of our test vehicle with the data of Audi R8. Generally, there can be two ways of entering parameters to be considered. First of all, the graphical user interface based approach, the vehicle dataset editor, as already shown. Parameters are adjusted by entering them in the corresponding field at the GUI. The second approach focuses on the modification of info files used in CarMaker. At this point, the question arises, what are the so-called info files in the context of CarMaker? Info files are ASCII files with specific format to guarantee an easy access by program code. At this point, we would like to give you a short insight into the structure of an info file to clarify its meaning. In CarMaker, different info files are used, which can contain different data, for example, the data of a test run or a vehicle dataset. In the following, we open an info file of a vehicle dataset in an installation directory, opening available section of cars via the main GUI. The browser appears, hitting the designated car with the right mouse button, and the dataset can be opened in an editor as info file, like I shown you before. The vehicle file includes all the parameters, with its values to adjust the model accordingly. It is structured relating to different domains of car, for example assembly or body, as you can see here. The structure is identical to the selection of the GUI to parameterize the vehicle dataset. An important fact is the addressing of the several parameters. Based on the type of parameters, the syntax for each of those can differ depending on the parameters. Values can be entered as a single value, as you can see here, for arrow AX, or as in vector form for the arrow maker pos. The third option to enter values is the type of a matrix you see at arrow coefficient. In addition to the editing of the vehicle dataset, it is helpful to have a closer look on the CarMaker coordinate system. The designation of the coordinate system CarMaker is frames. We are going to have a short look on the frames available in CarMaker and the origin they are using. A detailed description of the frames is given in the reference menu in the section for the CarMaker access system. It is essential to know that CarMaker different access systems for different purposes are used. First of all, simplifying calculations and parameterizing for CarMaker objects. Second of all, the representing of different point of views in CarMaker objects. And first of all, there are a global access system in CarMaker, which is an inertia system that represents the origin of a virtual world in CarMaker. It is called frame zero. Note the origin of the frame zero coordinate system is set by defining the first road element in the scenario data. In addition, the user should be aware of the fact that the position of any point, if not mentioned, is expressed in frame zero. Moving objects in the virtual world of CarMaker are based on their own accompanying access system, which is called frame one. The access system is fixed to the moving object, meaning that the movement of the coordinate system performs all the translations and rotations the object is doing. The assembly tab under graphics in the vehicle dataset gives some kind of impression where frame 1 is located. Frame 1 is defined as follows. It is located at the hitch position of the car projected to the ground. X points forwards in driving direction, epsilon points to the left, and Z defines upwards. For every wheel, there's a mounting point defined within the frame 1 system. This is the center of the reference of the frame 2 axis system attached to the mounting point of a wheel. Frame 2 is representing the poor translation of the frame 1 axis system. Additionally, there's another frame, frame engine, which can be used in case of an elastically mounted engine. The motion of the engine frame relative to the vehicle frame is defined by 5 degrees of freedom. Another important frame is the design frame. The design frame is parallel axis system to frame 1, with different origin. It is used to specify geometry input coordinates, which are based on a different origin than frame 1, without recomputing them. If the customer got the self-defined origin of his axis system, used the design, the car in his construction process, CarMaker refers to data to the design frame from frame 1 point of view. In the following, we are going to have a look at the parameterization techniques. Basically, the vehicle model can be parameterized in 2 levels of detail. On the one hand, the basic parameterization with the help of the vehicle dataset generator. On the other hand, the full parameterization by request from IPG Automotive can be used. It is important to mention that the level of detail of parameterization has direct influence of the quality of the simulation results. Depending on application, the basic parameterization can be fully sufficient. You will find the generator option in the already introduced drop-down menu, where you can load, save, and import vehicle-specific datasets. It is the most down option in the menu. The generator is used to create generic vehicle parameter datasets based on the most common vehicle classes as small, compact, medium, luxury cars or vans. No detailed information of the vehicle are required. The user can choose the level of detail by setting the parameters for his use case. Using generic vehicle datasets can be very helpful in case the user just needs a vehicle environment to test, for example, his controllers or sensors. Let's create a vehicle dataset of a medium car by making use of the generator. I already selected the medium car and placed the names. The vehicle class shall be a medium car, as the name already indicates. We are going to change the wheelbase to 2900 mm and set the unloaded weight to 1500 kg. The advanced settings offer additional parameters, for example, the engine nominal power. We are going to set it to 150 kW. After hitting the generate button, a vehicle model is created automatically, which is stored in a vehicle folder of the project directory. As you can see, it's already loaded as a vehicle model in the main GUI for the next test run. This model now can be used for the testing purpose or further improvements.